Euler's totient function phi of n, which is also known as Euler's phi function. So what is phi of n? It is a set of positive numbers less than n, which are relatively prime to n. Right? So let me consider a number n. So Euler's totient function phi of n is a set of positive numbers which is less than n, but they are relatively prime to n. So now we need to know what relative prime numbers are. So let us consider two numbers n1 and n2. Now these two numbers are considered to be relatively prime if the GCD of these two numbers is equal to 1. That means the greatest common number which divides these two would be 1. Now let's take an example. Let me consider the number 3 and number 5. No doubt these two numbers are prime numbers, and the only number which divides both 3 and 5 is 1. Right? 3 is divisible by 1, 5 is divisible by 1, and there are no other numbers, common numbers, which can divide both 3 and 5. Now this is true when one of the numbers is a prime, or both the numbers are prime. So now if I consider another case where we have 5 and I consider 12, what is GCD? GCD of these two is 1. Why? Because 5 is a prime number and 12 is not a prime number, but the number which divides both 5 and 12 is 1. So if we want to choose two numbers which are relatively prime, we can choose one of the numbers as a prime number and the other number should not be a multiple of that prime number. Then those two numbers will definitely be relatively prime. Right? So let's take another case. 8 and 9. Now 8 and 9 are not prime numbers, but I find that the only number which can divide both 8 and 9 is 1. So GCD of 8 and 9 is 1. Now why is that so? We observe that any two consecutive numbers are always relatively prime. Right? So we can take any two consecutive numbers, say 14, 15, 20, 21. They are always relatively prime. Okay? So what are relatively prime numbers? Relatively prime numbers are numbers whose GCD is equal to 1. Okay? So we have considered a few examples here where the numbers are relatively prime. So now let's talk about Euler's totient function. So Euler's totient function phi of n will give all the numbers which are relatively prime to n, but which is less than n. So let's take the case of say phi of 5. Since 5 is a prime number, all the numbers less than 5 are relatively prime to 5, isn't it? So 1, 2, 3, 4. If I consider 1 and 5, GCD is 1. If I consider 2 and 5, GCD is 1. 3 and 5, GCD is 1. 4 and 5, GCD is 1. So if this number n happens to be a prime number, then all the numbers which are less than the given prime number are relatively prime. So phi of 5 is equal to 4. So there are 4 numbers which are relatively prime to 5. So in general, phi of p equals p minus 1. Right? Phi of p equals p minus 1. Where p happens to be a prime number. So how do I find the Euler's totient function of phi of p? It is just p minus 1. Right. So if you don't have a prime number, so if n is not a prime number, then how do we find Euler's totient function? So let's take the case where n is not a prime number, 15. Okay. So now we need to list out all the numbers which are relatively prime to 15. So let's try and list out all the numbers which are relatively prime to 15. So if the given number is not a prime but can be represented as a product of two different prime numbers. So here I've considered 15, where 15 can be written as 3 into 5, where both 3 and 5 are prime numbers. Then in that case, 5 of 15 is nothing but equal to 5 of 3 into 5 of 5. So what is 5 of 3? 5 of 3 is 2 and 5 of 5 is 4. So there are 8 numbers less than 15 which are relatively prime to 15. So to find the Euler's totient function for numbers which are not prime, I can write the given number as a multiple of prime numbers, and of course they should not repeat. So in that case it is nothing but, so if I have phi of n, which can be written as phi of p1 into p2 into p3 and so on, so that is nothing but phi of p1 into phi of p2 into phi of p3 and so on. So that will be p1 minus 1, p2 minus 1, p3 minus 1 and so on. Okay, so it is 2 into 4, we get 8. So phi of 15 is 8. So let's take another example. So what is phi of 231? Now can this number be represented as multiple of different primes? Let's check. Let me divide 231 by 3. Right? So I get 7 into 7. Right? So now I can divide this by 7, I get 11. So I have all prime numbers which are not repeating again. So this is phi of 3 into 7 into 11. So this can be written as phi of 3 into phi of 7 into phi of 11. So phi of 3 is 3 minus 1, which is 2. Phi of 7 is 7 minus 1, which is 6. Phi of 11 is 11 minus 1, which is 10. So we get 6 into 2 is 12 into 10 is 120. So there are 120 numbers less than 231 which are relatively prime to 231.